Hello everybody, Phonic Arts here. This is an updated version of my previous video. Worried about phishers? Look here for guidance. This video will be more detailed and in-depth than the last, and will cover the three most popular places to see phishing links, emails, and such. And the three biggest places is YouTube, Facebook, and your email. Now, first question, what is phishing? And phishing is the attempt to acquire information, and sometimes indirectly money, using fake websites to acquire usernames, password, and credit card details by masquerading as a trustworthy entity. Now, phishing is carried out by email spoofing, using instant messages, and often directs users to enter details at a fake websites, which whose looks and feel are almost identical to the real one. Now, phishing is illegal. I won't lie. I'll tell you straight. Phishing is illegal, and it is a federal crime in the United States, and it's probably a federal crime worldwide. So I guess to show off the first place, I'll show off one of the biggest places that you can find, or the biggest phisher I've seen on Facebook, and that's One All Day Giveaways. He has links saying posts and forums, and there's some place you can scroll down, and I mean there's one guy who's smart. And, I mean, this kid is obviously too young to realize this, and this guy's smart enough to actually tell them. And it's annoying at times, I won't lie. So, let's go ahead and get to the next thing. Where can I find other things? You can find them in email. These are emails that, say, Jag8LTD has emailed me, saying there's lawsuits against me, I have black marks on my character, and stuff like that, which all those are fake. Now you see this was 9 at 43, and there was a reply from me. Now let's go ahead and just say just take a look through. And it says legal at Jagex, no reply at Jagex. And it's just trying to go through a different... It's basically spoofing emails. Now, what is this? This is known as malicious email. And I'll explain it right here. Now, it's also spam, but it's phishing and spoofing. Phishing is an email fraud method, which it sends legitimate-looking email in its attempt to gather personal information. This spoofing is spoofing the actual site and such. Now, first off, I'll go and open up the email because I know what it is. There's nothing malicious inside the email in your email inbox, but the link is the malicious part of it. So, to go from there, you got the email. Well, you're like, well, Jagex doesn't know I get these emails. Yes, they can. All you got to do is forward the email. Forward this to reportphishing@jagex.com. And what it does is it will send a copy of that email forwarded from you, the player, to them. Now, what they'll do then is they'll check that email, check the link, and will either deem it malicious or not. But it most likely it'll be deemed malicious. So they'll probably, email or get a hold of the domain owner for the one who's trying to run that, and get it shut down. And that's pretty much the simplest thing. Alright, the final place. We have YouTube. And as you see, they have links down here, and I'm going to go ahead and click it. And they try to fool you with this. And this is the first time I've seen this kind of one. So I'll drag this over here with the other. So, I have one of these win all day giveaway links open, so I'm going to exit out of win all days, and you see it's this. Well, first thing I want you to do, instead of posting on it, I want you to click this arrow. If it goes to the next page, then I'll give it a little bit of honesty and take a look, bit closer look at it. But this is a phishing link. I click the arrow, it reloads the same page. It's phishing. Exit out. Nothing needed. Alright, this one is a little different. Now, in the case of this one, you want to see, how can I tell this is a legitimate site? Because they take you to the secure login page. Here's the difference. Well, right now the background's cut off. But let's try this. View page source. I see some different things right here that shouldn't be here. There's a runescapesr.com, fave icon, and such. Now, let's view the legitimate page. View page source. You've got all this HTML code. Alright. Let's go ahead and exit out of this HTML code. Now, you see that, and I'll show you in a side-by-side comparison. Look at the left hand. You see, this site has not verified its identification, and this is offering a digital certificate of this saying it's Jagex. Now, you might want to know, what are digital certificates? I have up here is what a certificate authority is. They offer digital certificates. You've heard of VeriSign? That's a certificate authority. Now, I'll do it like this. Alright. Public key certificates, known as a digital certificate, which is an electronic document which uses a digital certificate to bind a public key to an identity. Information such as the name of the person, organization, and so forth. This certificate can be verified that the public key belongs to them. Now, PKI infrastructure, and I've learned this in my infrastructure class, mainly with servers. This makes it easy to prove that they are who they say they are. And if you want me to prove it, I can click on the certificate to open it. What's this site have? They ain't got no certificate. I mean, it just says straight up, I don't have a certificate. And this is supposed, and it says secure right here. It doesn't matter if it says secure. You see right here, it says HTTPS secure. You know what this, you know what you try to do if you type HTTPS? It's not, their server refused connection. So this one here is actually, instead of HTTPS, this is HTTP. And that's what it is. It's HTTP versus HTTPS. Now, you might want to know, what is HTTPS? And I'll drag that back over here. What is HTTPS? HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, the primary protocol for the web. Now, HTTPS is Hyper Transfer Protocol with Secure Socket Layer. This is developed with secure, safe internet transactions in mind. Now, when you go through like Amazon and eBay and, anything that requires you to, enter personal credit card information, it will be through HTTPS. And let's see, I don't know if I have Mozilla Firefox. Let's see. Yeah, I have Firefox. Hold on. I'll open up Firefox and let's see, RuneScape forums. I want to actually pull up a secure site, the secure RuneScape site on this and see if I can find something. All right. I'll drag this over. Now, as you see, I'm on the secure one. I'm at the official Jagex login. And you can see, this will offer the certificate as well. This will show the certificate. It also has the green lock and says it's Jagex Limited in Great Britain. I have Internet Explorer as well, and I'll do it as well. RuneScape.com. And I'm doing the other stuff off screen just to open it up real quick. And let's just all right, going to the forum. Give me just a second. All right, and with Internet Explorer, this is IE9. You'll see that the bar is green. Now, the green bar means it is secure and that it's using secure socket layer. You can click on the locked part up here, and it will show the digital certificates. You can view them as well, just like in Google Chrome. Now, there's ways in all three browsers that it'll show that it's a secure one. A lot of it being it'll actually say who owns it. Like it says right here, Jagex. In this one, it says it's off owned by Jagex as well. And even in Google Chrome, it shows it's Jagex. Now, as I said, this shows HTTP and what HTTPS. Now, if you happen to have another account, and I'm about to exit out that one, that was the phishing one. Let's go ahead and back up. Now, if you get hacked and you have another account that can post in the forums, go to Account Help. And they'll give you some things about your account. No longer ha you can account manually recover your account, and it'll explain. Click on the thing, and it'll explain how. Click login. Remember to log in, then click the forgotten password, and we'll send you to a site where you log in using your original username. Your original username. If you create your account after November 2010, this will be your email address. But this will be used using your original username. So that will be a little bit of a difference. And yeah, this one is broke, so I'll just do it like this. Okay. So this will also go about safety tools. The safety center will also list parents info and how you can secure account that way as a parent. But say you get a key logger, and this is something I want y'all to actually know about. If you get a key loggers do not come through phishing links. That is not a keylogger. Phishing links take what you type in. So if you type in half of what you're typing, and then realize it, and don't hit enter or submit or anything like that, it won't remember you even. It won't even say you did that. It'll just be like, hey, this person visited a site. They didn't give us anything. Okay. Or it might not even tell you them that. So there's many ways you can secure your account, and I'll pull these up here on a different thing. And what I'm going to open, what I have opened up is stuff like antiviruses that you can use. Okay, and the first one you see here is Microsoft Security Essentials. This is the official download from Microsoft, and it works great, and this is free. The full version is completely free. All right, and as you see, this is from Windows, actual Microsoft's page. Now, here's a, and FileHippo is a basically a holding site for a lot of files, and I use it for keeping up to date on stuff. Now, this is Avast free antivirus, and this is the free edition for non-commercial and home use. And there's just a few things you can do like with that. And they'll list the more versions of it on here on the side, so you can always get a previous version if you need it. Most people has heard of malware bytes, and this is good for malware, anti-malware, And, you know, they'll have previous versions on the side. It'll give a description, change log, technical information, and all. Now, here's Avira. This is Antivirus Personal. This is a free antivirus. There is a full edition as well. And it'll also show, you know, details, technical, and comments. Next up is AVG. Most people have heard of this. My local college actually uses AVG for their computers. And I've used it before. I won't say there's nothing wrong with it at all. Next up is the 64-bit edition of AVG. And here's something if you ever get hacked. And this will tell you customer service notices. And this will also give you technical help, account help. You can use account recovery. And, you know, general account query, account recovery. This will list forgotten passwords and such like that. I hope this video was more detailed. I'll give links in the description to the websites that my antivirus websites, along with the account help and such. But do keep in mind that you can tell a phishing link from the official link by just comparing them very closely. I mean, you can take a regular if you want to compare the forums ones and they're going to a forum thread, take the quick find code. If most likely if the quick find code does not match what the your trusted official Jagex forum says, then you know it's phishing. If it's the same, try going to the next page. I mean, there's multiple ways you can try it. I just hope this video has helped, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye.